Following in the footsteps of Mini, Fiat re-entered the US market with a teeny little car, the 500, that paid homage to an even tinier, decades-old icon of cuteness of the same name. But brands like Mini and Fiat cannot survive on one product alone, and inevitably the time comes to add derivative models. But whereas Mini's attractive, Cooper-inspired clubman and countryman models were largely credible efforts, Fiat's attempt to scale up the 500 resulted in the gawky 500 liters. Fiat's more crossover-like 500X, which came a bit later, is rather more successful than the 500 liters. But the 500 liters does have the advantage in interior space and versatility with a taller roof, huge windows, and excellent outward visibility. That said, there's little that the Fiat 500 liters does that the 500X doesn't do better. But whereas Mini's attractive, Cooper-inspired clubman and countryman models were largely credible efforts, Fiat's attempt to scale up the 500 resulted in the gawky 500 liters. Fiat's more crossover-like 500X, which came a bit later, is rather more successful than the 500 liters. But the 500 liters does have the advantage in interior space and versatility with a taller roof, huge windows, and excellent outward visibility. That said, there's little that the Fiat 500 liters does that the 500X doesn't do better. Exterior styling tweaks, updated infotainment systems, and a revised dashboard and center console attempt to keep the 500 liters fresh for 2018. The three trim levels remain, the base pop, the more comfortable lounge, and the more rugged-looking trekking, the last getting its own styling treatment evocative of the 500X.